critically acclaimed TV series Puberty Blues wound up this week, but if you missed it, it is out on DVD right now. I caught up with star Jeremy Lindsay Taylor, who played Martin Vickers, to discuss why the show worked so well and whether rumours of a sequel might be true. So, Jeremy, we're sitting here watching the last episode go to air. What are your feelings?
Pride, really. Yeah, it's just an amazing experience. And what an amazing cast and crew and, you know, just one of those jobs that you just... It's going to work. It's not really going to work. You know, blessed.
So the contract's arrived.
Blessed. And it's such an iconic... story, an iconic book, and you know, so many people relate to it and remember it, and so this was so important that it was on the money, because it could have been, you know, it's so dear to people in Australian history, you know, an integral part, and yeah, just proud of the product.
Where are the sideburns?
Yeah, sideburns are gone, and the back's gone, and basically the helmet's gone.
Do you miss that look?
Yeah, I do actually. I miss a lot of it. I miss Martin and the whole gang actually a lot. Yeah, it was an enjoyable experience and challenging and exciting and yeah, I just praying I get to grow my hair again and hopefully we do another one.
Yeah, well, there is talk of season two of Puberty Blues. Where's that at?
There's talk. And that's where it's at. So I don't know anything. There's nothing official yet. But I mean, it's been critically acclaimed, and it's been the ratings have been fantastic. And yeah, I mean, I couldn't be prouder of the production. So you know, fingers crossed. All the
and you're prepared to grow facial hair again if necessary.
Yes, yes, most definitely.
You're a good man. Definitely. What was it like? People have. Really taking this series to heart, it's brought back memories of a particular era. First of all, what was it like to recreate that era that, you know, you lived through yourself?
Yeah, amazing, you know. As you can see by the production values, it's you are in the 70s. And, you know, I've got mates who try and pause it and try and find, pick something that's, and they just can't do it. And, you know, it's that authenticity and that nostalgia that I think audiences are just embracing and loving, you know. They're going back there, you know, it's like they're back in the 70s. So it's taking a lot of people back and it's, you know, really proud of that.
Some of these things
yeah.
that we've got here take me back.
Yeah.
The cheesels on the fingers.
The cheesels, yeah.
Yeah, absolutely. What else is there?
the Vaso, which gets... a lot of use in Puberty Blues, myself included.
Your mum was proud of those scenes, was she?
Yeah, yeah.
Very, excellent.
Very proud, you know. She'd never experienced me doing that before, so, growing up. So, but I did actually just recently get on a plane and I was queuing up and I was obviously queuing in the wrong section. Angela was the first class and I didn't realise that. And I said, oh, am I in the right place? And the guy says, mate, I've seen what you can do with a jar of Asso. You can queue up anywhere. And he checked me in. I got an upgrade.
Some awesome cars in the show too. I think he didn't look very closely at your contract because I noticed that Roger scored the Triumph Stag.
Mm-hmm. Roger, of course, scored that. Yes.
Yeah.
And the mustache.
Yeah.
He got to grow one of those. But yeah, I know. I mean, I love the Kingswood though.
Yeah, sure.
It's amazing. It's you know, it's an institution.
That is true.
The Kingswood. So.
Without we take it very lightly, and we have had this nostalgic ride, but the series tackled some really heavy stuff as well, which is the reason it resonates with people is because it was so true to life.
Yeah.
What was it like, you know, tackling some of that darker stuff?
Really enlightening. You know, that Australian drama tackled it in such a or head on, you know. Audiences are smart. You can't fool people or insult their intelligence. So I think a lot of the amazing television coming out of this country now, and you know, in particular, you know, America's setting a benchmark of really quality drama. So audiences expect, you know, and are wise to when they're, you know, being tricked or, you know, you're sugarcoating something. It's like, oh, they won't bother watching that. So this is kind of revolutionary for Australian drama, I think. It's really set a benchmark and raised the bar. And yeah, we you can't lie to audiences anymore, you know, and people really... they're drawn to that, I think, and really appreciate that, and so they're really sucked into this world and become a part of it and really care about the characters. So then when you take them on these tough journeys and take them, put them through the ringer, the audience go with them, and that's what television's all about.
If you had to speculate on Puberty Blues 2, where would it go?
Well, that's the beauty. It can go anywhere. I mean, that... in terms of all the families, they're all so different and, you know, multifaceted. It's just, it could go anywhere. The girls, you know, I dread to think what the girls are going to get up to. And
might be worth a chat to Kathy Lett.
Yes.
One of them might end up marrying a famous QC.
Yes, yeah, and continue on writing. And yeah, but I could go anywhere. I mean, I think Martin Vickers could become anything, you know. He's kind of pretty out there and a bit weird, and yeah, there's a lot going on. I think there can be a lot more explored there, and Judy and yeah, David's growing up, and you got the girls getting up to no good, and all the families, and I mean, it's the Shire in the 70s. It can just, yeah, I think, and the team of writers are just brilliant. I mean, never before have I picked up a script and you don't want to change a word.
Wow.
That's pretty special. So, you know, awesome. Hats off to them, and that's why the product's so good. So, fingers crossed.